What if, like this lucky chap here, one could cheat death? Benjamin Franklin wrote, "The only thing certain is death and taxes." But what if he was only half right? What if you were in fact fated or cursed to live and pay taxes forever?
The upper limit of the human lifespan is about 120 years. Scientists, who treat aging like a curable disease, have made some progress in rejuvenating the human body. If they are eventually successful, if they cure aging, humans still wouldn't be technically immortal. Death by violence and misadventure would still claim lives, so what exactly would allow you to live forever?
Interesting question, Marceline. It has to do with how strange the fabric of reality is, according to a bunch of dead Germans. Here's some context. In 1957, a physicist named Hugh Everett, seeking to explain the strange and contradictory nature of quantum mechanics, came up with an idea that would be called the many worlds theory. You see, in the quantum world of very small things, nothing can be known until it's measured, and when it's measured, it changes states. An example of this is the famous Schrödinger's cat thought experiment. The setup is this: a theoretical, not at all real cat is placed in a sealed box, along with a small amount of radioactive material, a Geiger counter, and a flask of poison gas. If a particle from the radioactive material decays within an hour, it will trigger the counter and release the poison, killing the cat. Since, according to quantum physics, the radioactive particles involved exist in multiple states until they're measured, and their measurement decides the fate of the cat, then, until someone opens the box and observes it, the cat would be both alive and dead at the same time, or in what's called a superposition state. But most people's common sense tells them the cat must realistically be either alive or dead, not both. In fact, Schrödinger posed his paradox to illustrate what he saw as the absurdity and limitations of this interpretation of quantum physics. But at the end of the day, the data still says that our reality is kind of like a random fog of math that doesn't condensate into rain until someone is there to pop open an umbrella. Physicists call this wave function collapse. Hugh Everett's many worlds interpretation sought to resolve this bit of perplexion by suggesting that both possibilities, the cat alive and the cat dead, occur in different branches of a multiverse, with no wave function collapse required.
The many worlds theory says that every time there's a choice, a new universe is born to accommodate every possible outcome. So if a particle could go left or right, it actually goes both directions, just in two different universes. And that applies to you too. That means there's a universe where you chose spaghetti for breakfast instead of eggs, the universe where you're wearing high heels right now, the universe where you're a plastic surgeon, and so on.
Everett's big idea, though a bit mad, solves some very thorny questions in quantum physics. But what does it have to do with living forever? Well, one of the more profound and unsettling implications of the many worlds theory is called quantum immortality. According to this interpretation, since the universe is continually splitting into multiple alternate histories every time you say buy a lottery ticket, then despite the tiny odds of winning, there will always be a universe where you're a millionaire, and so also there must be a universe where you cannot die. Let me explain. In most of these alternate histories, we live ordinary lives and eventually experience normal death. However, there is always some small chance in any given moment that quantum randomness, what we might call pure luck, could lead to an unlikely survival scenario. For instance, perhaps you're in exactly the right spot to survive a massive earthquake, or a cure for a normally fatal disease is devised in the nick of time, or you miss a doomed airplane because your pet rabbit contracts rabies. The odds of such improbable events are, of course, infinitesimally small, but in an infinite multiverse, such unlikely worlds must necessarily exist somewhere. So while the versions of you in most of these alternate histories eventually die, the subjective experience from your point of view is that you continue living on in that exceedingly rare quantum branch where you somehow survived against all odds. Thus, from your perspective, life would appear as an endless continuum of exceedingly improbable events leading to a godlike immortality.
In fact, everyone would inhabit at least one universe where they simply didn't die, like a video game character respawning endlessly right where they left off, completely unaware that they've just been eaten by zombies. The flip side of this sort of immortality is that there would also be almost infinite universes where you were never born. In fact, near infinite universes where no one has ever been born.
Quantum immortality is more of a philosophical speculation than a scientifically testable hypothesis. The core problem is that quantum immortality is predicated on your own personal experience of avoiding death indefinitely across multiple alternate histories. But we have no way to objectively measure or observe these subjective viewpoints outside of our own. In other words, since we may be inside this multiverse, our very viewpoints cannot be trusted to give us accurate data. But the thing that's interesting about quantum immortality is that, in a way, it feels intuitively true. Think about this. In order to be watching this film, you must have already survived countless close calls with death, most you'll never even be aware of. And not just you, but every one of your ancestors as well. Why, in order to even exist right now, looking at this rabbit is an astonishingly improbable event. You, sitting there on that dusty couch, may well be a god.